What's going on, guys? I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, coming at you with another Dokkan battle video today. As I'm sure you could surmise from the title, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to get all the global Porunga Dragon Balls in today's video. I recognize that this is a little premature considering Global's 3-year anniversary hasn't technically started at the time of this filming. However, I'm making this video now because I don't want to be doing many 30-second daily videos throughout the celebration. This way, you guys have all the information you need in one tidy little package. You can just bookmark it to your browser or save it to a playlist and return to it daily to collect your Dragon Balls. By the way, I want to give a big shout out to data miner iSeriously for all the information in this video. He was the one who determined that while most of the missions are the same, there are some minor differences between the Porunga missions on Global compared to JP. According to iSeriously, we will be able to collect our first Namekian Dragon Ball starting on Saturday, July 7th. From there, we can collect one additional Dragon Ball every single day. Whenever we collect a set of 7 Dragon Balls, we will be able to summon Porunga and make 3 wishes. In total, we will collect 21 Dragon Balls over 21 days and make 3 sets of wishes. Just to avoid any confusion, I will refer to each ball by the set and order we obtain them in. So the first ball we collect on July 7th will be set 1, ball 1, the next one will be set 1, ball 2, and so on and so forth. If you guys have any further questions, just leave it down in the comments and I will try my best to get back to you in a timely manner. All set? Let's get started then. Starting with set 1, ball 1. To get this Dragon Ball, all you have to do is train a character. That's it. Set 1, ball 2. Press the button to switch from quest to event 3 times. So all you have to do is literally press this button 3 times and you will get your Dragon Ball. Set 1, ball 3. Finish a quest with a Gohan Kid character on your team. So this SR Kid Gohan works perfectly fine. The free-to-play Strength Kid Gohan that's about to be released also works. Basically any character with Gohan bracket Kid as their name will be perfectly fine. Set 1, ball 4. Try adding yourself as a friend. So literally all you have to do is go to friend search, type your own friend code in, and try to add yourself, and you're done. Set 1, ball 5. Go to the summon screen, hit the scouter button to display the featured units. So just go to any banner, hit scouter, look at the featured units, and that's it. Set 1, ball 6. Finish an awakening medal stage. So any of the stages in this event should work just fine. Set 1, ball 7. Press the question mark banner on the main page. I believe it will be one of these scrolling banners at the bottom here. You just have to go through it and find the question mark and click it. At this point, you should have completed your first set of Dragon Balls and make your first set of Porunga wishes. Set 2, ball 1. Go to your character list screen and click on the numbers at the bottom of the screen. So literally just this button here that makes you scroll all the way to the bottom. Set 2, ball 2. Awaken a character that uses a Korin Awakening medal. So any character that uses this medal right here. Set 2, ball 3. Rotate the character wheel on the main screen 7 times. So literally you just have to go like this 7 times and you're good to go. Set 2, ball 4. Do a friend summon. Set 2, ball 5. Use 50 stamina. Set 2, ball 6. Buy something in the Baba shop with Baba points. Set 2, ball 7. Z awaken a character. At this point, you should have finished collecting your second set of Namekian Dragon Balls and summoned Porunga for your second set of wishes. Set 3, ball 1. Finish a Dokkan event. Set 3, ball 2. Dokkan awaken a card. Set 3, ball 3. Go to the Pilaf's Trove page. So just hit that, and that's it. Set 3, ball 4, train at Korin's Tower, which I believe they're referring to this event right here. Set 3, ball 5, finish a hidden potential level. So right now we have the physical one up, but whatever's available to you at the time, just do that one. Set 3, ball 6, raise the hidden potential of a character. One node should be enough. Set 3, ball 7, finish a level with a monotype team. So basically a team where all the units are the same type. The Super AGL team, for example, would work just fine. At this point, you should have collected all the Dragon Balls you need for your third and final set of Porunga wishes. That's gonna do it for the video, guys. Hope you found it useful. Like I said, if you have any questions, leave it down in the comments and I'll make sure to get back to you as soon as possible. Aside from that, if you liked the video, make sure to like the damn video. If this is your first time watching me and you like what you see, then I don't know, maybe hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. But as always, hope you guys have a fantastic day. This is Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.